Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Neverwinter Nights, Shadows of Undrentide. As per usual, we're just gonna jump on in here. Now, this episode, I am actually recording somewhat differently than usual. I am going the route of OBS here. In theory, this should be recording in 60 frames per second. And in addition to that, I'm using OBS multi-platform to do this, so I should have dual audio tracks, which will make editing this a breeze. It should be like editing anything I record with the xTory. So, we're gonna jump on in here, and ideally the game will perform adequately. I did some testing, and it's running 60 frames per second for me here. I'm hoping that there's not any jittering or anything while we play, so ideally this will run well. And in addition to that, I found that with... Thanks, Dorna, you're just... your champion. I found that in addition to that, with OBS multi-platform, unlike regular OBS, I can actually have it use my video card to do the video encoding. So normally, I tried this without doing my video, having my video card do it, and my CPU would sit at about 60% usage. I'm having my video card do the encoding for this. My CPU is sitting at 3% usage. It's pretty nice, that's what these tracks say. Large group of humanoids came from the foothills and headed north across a stream. Okay, and we did gain a level last time, although we didn't really gain anything too interesting from it, I believe. I think we just gained some new spells, which basically amounted to an extra bull strength and summon creature to replace the boar should he go down. Honestly, I'm kind of tempted to take just a second summon monster too instead of a bull strength, but I'm going to pass on that for now because more or less, I want to be able to re-roll it if I get a really crappy roll. So I am going to move this over here. I'm gonna cast Identify, and we're gonna find out what this katana and ring are. So a katana of the north and a ring of animal friendship. What is with all of this druid stuff? That's actually a really good good ring, plus 12 to animal empathy. With this katana of the north, crafted by a small order of monks in the Nether Mountains, it grants its wielders some protection from the harsh elements of the north, as well as having a calming influence on beasts that may be encountered. Additional animal empathy, plus 1 to attacks and massive crits for 1 to 4 extra damage, and it can do endure elements twice a day. I'm actually going to use that over my bastard sword because I believe mechanically katanas are the same in this. I think D10, 19, 20 times 2. D10, 19, 20 times 2, yeah. Alright, so mechanically they are the same, but they are different weapons with regards for feats and whatnot, which I think is kind of silly, but whatever. So we are now a European samurai, I guess. And our. Oh. Wyrmling White Dragons. Okay, challenge rating on them is moderate, so yeah, that's what I was waiting for. So they're gonna probably be more annoying than anything. I don't really expect them to be particularly lethal, especially to me, because I have that, I believe it's my necklace of cold resistance? Yes, that's gonna, I'm sure, be something that's useful to us for a while here. So we have somebody dead in here. Maybe this endure elements. Can I actually cast it? I wanna see what it does. Damage resistance 10 against all forms of elemental damage, ends after absorbing 20 points of damage from any elemental type. Okay, so that's actually halfway useful. What I want to see is, can I cast this? I can. There. So now she's got some protection against their breath weapons, which might actually be useful because it seems like they were only doing like a point to my boar, who's very near to death, but I'm not too worried about him anyways. Oh, we got some reds in here. A red? No, two. Alright. Ah! Avast, have at thee. I've got 48 hit points. Oh, three of them. Come on, guys. There we go. These guys aren't bad experience. 77 apiece. We've got to earn, like, 5,000, I think, to gain our next level. I think that's what it said. Yeah. So, we've got some work ahead of us. Next level will be nice. We will pick up third level spells, which as a cleric, nothing really too insane there. I don't even really think I have any second level spells that I would extend, because Bull's Strength, for example, lasts for whatever it is, an hour a level. So, not too. Oh, they have a tiny little horde. It's adorable, a great axe, and some gold, and a dragon egg. Dragon egg found in a cave full of wyrmlings. Such eggs are often highly sought after by wizards and other arcanists. I bet you I know a wizard of Thay who would probably be interested in that. We'll take the heavy flail too. And a corpse with an aventurine and some gold pieces. Oh. And a two-bladed sword, because, yeah. I don't think in all of my time playing pen and paper, well, since playing 3rd edition, I don't think I've ever seen anyone use a double. No, I take that back. I've seen one player use a double weapon in pen and paper. Night Hammer and Outrider will know Steve has something of a fondness for. I believe they were called Dwarven Urgroshes, where they were an axe on one end and a spear on the other. And we're gonna sleep.
My pack is too heavy. It is awkward.
Yeah, your pack's always gonna be too heavy until we get you some strength boosting items. Okay. There we go. Let's see if we can't get us a good roll. 21 is acceptable. I will not go for broke on that. I'm basically gonna be happy as long as I'm at least at a 20. Because that will net me the ability to carry all of my crap. And I'm actually really impressed by how this is running. I've noticed a little bit of hitching, but I think that's just kind of the game, more so than due to recording. Come on, guys. Like, I'm just waiting for me to accidentally move my mouse cursor a little too far right, like that, and have the camera just spaz out. I've done that maybe once or twice thus far, and it's something that's probably going to be a continuing problem. But no, I'm actually really happy with how OBS is handling this, and it's certainly something that I'm going to have to keep in mind. I'm actually using, for this game, I'm using the less optimal of their recordings. I'm actually recording my desktop, like my entire monitor, because OBS won't pick up the actual game, but if I have it record my monitor, the game's there and it has to. And I know that if you record the actual game, it uses even fewer resources, so. Yeah, it's good to know. Hey, Hermit! Hello, Hermit.
Can I help you?
What is it that brings you to the home of a humble child of the Lady's Peace? On second thought, forget that I asked. It's none of my business so long as you bring no evil to my home. Listen, lad, I like it nice and quiet, so if you're being hunted by gnolls or assassins or chased by Sirik himself, I do not want to hear about it. I want nothing to do with your problems, I do not want to even know your name. I would like your gold, though. So you can buy some of my magical goods, or I can teleport you somewhere. Really, you'll just teleport me, okay. Would you be interested in buying a dragon egg? Well, now that does look like a valid specimen, and it just so happens that I know this great giant of a man who collects odd creatures. Works with some wizards, taking care of their beasts. That is a Harry Potter reference, referring to Hagrid, the groundskeeper. That's... I can kind of appreciate that. Suppose I could give you 700 gold for it. Don't even bother asking for more. You won't get it from me. What do you say?
Sure.
Good enough. Here's your gold and I will take the egg. Anything else? What do you have for sale? If you buy enough, maybe I won't have to go into Silvery Moon this year. That would be nice.
All right. Well, actually, I'm not so much buying as selling. Just gonna kind of offload a bunch of junk.
Ring of disease immunity. I don't know. I don't think I'm ever gonna use it. But I don't know that I'm never gonna use it.
I might hold on to it just in case we bump into like some more mummies or something. Alright, get rid of that. Alright, we're sitting at a get rid of this book too, because we actually found that hidden tomb. We're sitting at a pretty hefty sum of 4,500 gold pieces. That's not bad. Plus one charisma, that's useless. Plus one armor class, nice. And plus one to all saving throws. That's actually a pretty good cloak. but I don't think I want it. Boots of Striding, plus one Constitution, which I don't think will help us. No. You got anything fancy weaponry-wise? No. Oh, you've got stuff in here, though. Probably a bunch of stuff I can't even use. Potions of Lore, these cast, yeah, they cast Identify. Handy. Ventru's Lucky Charms. Plus one to all saves and plus three to lore. Now, I don't believe that will stack with our Ring of Scholars, so I'm not going to buy that. He does sell Rings of Protection, though. Yeah, this right here, this glittering necklace, this is what I thought that our Amulet of Cold Resist was. They just kind of shed light. That's what I thought it was. Improved saving throws, universal plus one. Ah, this guy, oh, I was gonna say, this guy doesn't really have anything I want, but it turns out, yes, he, oh. Go ahead and just, well, I already bought the magic pouch, so I'm gonna have to hold on to that. But I'm gonna buy a couple magic bags. Sweet. That will make storing our crap so much easier. So what do we have here? A Brooch of Shielding and a Chime of Opening, which I think casts Knock. Yes, I can cast Knock. So that's really of no great use. And some Quartz Crystals, which we've still got six of them. So I'm really not too worried about needing more. And I'm sure if I really need them, I can just go hunting somewhere and find them as opposed to paying this guy 15 gold pieces for them. Okay, what kind of armor do you have? You don't have any real armor. It's all caster stuff. And I really can't afford it anyways. Well, that's good. This will make organizing my inventory so much easier. Okay, so there's potions. I suppose this should just be like, I say, this will be my bag of curatives, but it's gonna be probably more than that. I'm gonna throw this in there, put it down there. Ring of Disease Immunity, I'll just throw in there, and this can sit in there. And these I will sell.
Can I help you?
Dang it, wrong button. Talk to you, sale, yes, please, buy these. Dorna, do you have anything? You have healing potions and that's it. Okay, so now let's actually talk to this guy. We can sell him the mummified hand, that's great. I wanna ask you some questions. I hate questions. Questions want answers, and answers are almost always wrong in one way or another. Who's the lady you spoke of? Mishca, the goddess of magic. You might have heard of her. Anything else? I'm looking for some magical artifacts that have been stolen. Has anyone tried to sell you any? We did have a young halfling in here about 10 or more years ago with a magic ruby magic ruby pendant, but he was not buying. I'm not sure he was selling either. He just kept playing with it. That's a reference to one of R.A. Salvatore's old novels. I think it's called The Halfling's Gem. Said he was headed for Icewind Dale. Yup. Though I never asked him. I have no idea if the item was stolen or what become of it, though. And I do not want to know either. It seemed rather powerful. Probably should have bought it. But for some reason, I can't remember, I decided against it. Seems strange to me now. You have any powerful magic items? I have a few. Just take a look at my inventory. Might have something you always wanted. A hermit in the middle of nowhere selling powerful magic items seems more than a little strange. Not so much more strange than a dwarf with sticky fingers traveling with a human cleric. Well, I suppose that might be true. I also have a magic recharging box, an invention of my own design. You'd have to pay to use it, though. What is it? Put magic items in that needed more charges and they recharged. How much does it cost? 100 gold for each charge. Ouch. Let's see, what else do you know? Do you know about the gnolls in the forest? Of course I know about them, but they have never managed to find my home, so I do not bother them. Give them no reason to look for me, and they'll stay away, so I believe. They've been a little more restless since that elf or whatever she was came into the forest. I do not like the looks of her, I tell you. I'm pretty confident in my abilities, but testing them against her, not a chance. There's something about her that's just not right. Looks like an elf, but that's about where the similarity ends. Really? You notice anything else about her? Heard one of the gnolls tell her something. Sounded like he was commenting on her jaw or he wanted something to gnaw. But you know how hard it is to understand anything a gnoll says. First of all, their teeth are too big. Now, if I was creating the world, I would have given them huge claws and retractable teeth. But the gods never really seemed to ask my advice. Okay, who are you? You see? That's exactly what I mean about questions. I can tell you my name, sure.
But would I be telling the truth? You'd have no idea. On the other hand, maybe I could tell you my name and think I'm telling the truth, but maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I just think that's my name, but in reality, my mother called me something else entirely. So, how about we avoid any personal questions so that I can avoid accidentally lying to you, hmm?
Really? We're not gonna, I don't think, bother persuading him. Honestly, Cheeriel would not care. So we'll ask you something else. That's enough questions. Goodbye.
Yes, go on, get out of here, and do not touch my recharging box unless you have the gold to pay for it.
I won't. Actually, I want to ask him about the teleportation. I want you to teleport me somewhere. There's 500 gold each time, and you can only go to the place you've been to before.
Ah, I'll walk.
Okay, so that's fast travel. Good to know. So is that his magic recharging box? Where's his magic recharging box? The temptation is the steel. But this guy seems pretty powerful, but stealing. I'm gonna save. Yes, I know, if I die, yada yada yada, but I just want to be able to reload if I die. All right, yoink. And in the barrel, a scroll of lesser restoration, sweet. Replace the one I accidentally sold to him earlier. Oh yes, I noticed, I just didn't say anything because I know I'm a jackass. Do we have anything over here? Oh, book piles. This is going to be another game that's going to inundate me with lore. The Alchemist's Cookbook. Amongst the interesting passages are, fenberries are a potent ingredient. The essence of several fenberries can be used to make the bark skin potion. A simple bottle is enough to hold the berry's essence. No special precautions are needed. Pure quartz crystal is another valuable reagent, necessary in many rituals that imbue magical power into various items. All right. I'm sure you collect bits and pieces of lore as you go, and it, like, you can use it to slowly piece together, oh, I need XYZ to craft item, you know, so on and so on. Okay, I want to check. Can't. Oh, I just accidentally clicked out of the game, apparently. I apologize for that. It should unfuck itself. I don't even know how I did that, honestly. I was just like clicking over here. My mouse wasn't out of the screen or anything. Weird. Oh, we have a cave. No, that's the cave with the dragons in it, I think. Unless I might have I don't think I missed anything in there. I might have, but Well, wasn't the wood we were supposed to be in going into the south anyways? I don't know. No, because this is the high forest, because when we loaded into it, it said, I think, high forest. Oh. You know, there's nothing in here. Just dragon hatchery, apparently. Yeah, this is high forest. Okay. So I gotta figure out how to get across this river. Unless it is shallow enough that I can just walk, which it is? Okay, it didn't look like it initially. That's why I didn't try just crossing over. But now that I look, yeah, you can actually, you know, see that there's a little land bridge under it. Okay, I'm gonna save my character, because I guess we want to do that. But I'm gonna save again, and here we go. Let's see how these gnolls fare. We've killed dragons, guys. Gnolls. Like, what's a gnoll gonna do to me? Is it gonna
Faith shall grant me victory!
Yep. That's what a gnoll's gonna do to me. Sit there taking a nap. Okay, nothing down there. Close the door. I tend to, yeah. Easy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, they look like they're all easy. Oh, we have a lieutenant that is moderate. There's a political joke there, but I'm not gonna make it. I bet you they're gonna hit that gong and it's gonna summon reinforcements and this is gonna go bad. That's why I'm throwing buffs. Hey guys! Where's that lieutenant at? There he is. Oh no, don't let him get to the gong. All right, I think, yeah.
That one's like, I thought better of this. Oh, wait. Oh, cleave. That is why I invest in cleave. It's not quite as useful in pen and paper as it is in Neverwinter Nights, but, oh, man, I love it. I'm gonna drink a healing potion to circulate wounds. If you listen closely, you can hear the brass gong resonating softly with your every step, as if it acknowledges your presence. A gong sentient, man. 99 sling bullets, less than intriguing. Penelope gem, and a chest. Healer's kit, plus one. Let's see, throw that into our healing sack. Unclose this, I actually want to really quick. These healer's kits are actually proving fairly useful, so I'm actually gonna go ahead and give them an honorary space on my hotbar. Hey look, it's some fenberries that can be used to make magical items and potions of bark skin. Ooh, we just read about that. It's like they were coaching us. A caged slave. Oh, I could have sworn. I was gonna say, I thought I saw some more gnolls over here. I'm still fully buffed, guys. Like, everything looks like targets right now. Any lieutenant? I don't think. Fireballs going off or something. Where's my boar? Oh, there's my boar. Okay. To say, I thought I lost him there for a second. Man, Dorna is just... She's having none of their shit, and she's getting the crap kicked out of her for it. Dorna, you really, really need to not... You need to not with the spells here. There. Hopefully that will disable her spell casting, and now she'll just focus on stabbing things to death like a good little rogue. I don't need another cleric. Little piece, wow. So awesome. Spirits, I'm not even gonna bother taking them. Some bones. Dude, 3 gold pieces? Come on, guys. Like, I know some DMs are a bit Monty Hall, but BioWare, you're going the opposite direction here. Oh, this is just... It's just like... I'm not going in there. That smells like a trap. Like, you go in and the door's shut. And holy crap! Oh, no! He just rung the bell, so I don't know what that's going to portend. Kill something, Dorna. I crit on a cleave. Oh, you guys. Provoke those attacks of opportunity. Oh, my hit points. Woo! Get out of there. Take a drink. Back to full health. God, the amount of healing. The healing that I get from freaking potions is just insane. I mean, it won't matter later in once I get access to potions of heal, assuming they give me access to potions of heal. But oof, for the time being, that's beefy. You all right there, Dorna? You need to be all right, Dorna. Till I kill this guy. All right. Here. Allow me! I'm the only person in this party that should actually be casting healing magic. She just... mm-mm. In general, in-combat healing in D&D is a bad idea, because the amount of healing that you get by comparison to the amount of damage that goes out on the average attack past, like, first level, it's basically a wasted action to heal somebody. Oh, a cage key. Hey there, buddy. Who are you, Glender? Glender, all right. Deal with you in a minute, I'm looting. These corpses have several gold pieces on them. And some sling bullets. All right, you wanted me to let you out?
Ah, you there. I don't know what you're doing here in these caves. I'll just thank my stars you're not a gnoll. My name's Glendir. Would you terribly mind letting me out of here?
Who are you?
I'm Glendir, the eldest son of the Baron of Hilltop. Of course, I'm quite valuable, alive at any rate. If you release me, I'm sure my father would reward you well.
There is no Baron of Hilltop.
Oh, well, I didn't know you knew that. Look, I told the gnolls that so they would think I was worth something as a hostage, so they wouldn't eat me. Can you blame me?
But we're not gnolls, obviously. Why lie to us?
Well, you could have been with the gnolls. How was I supposed to know?
You thought we were with the gnolls. Now that's just rich.
The truth is, I don't have any money. Everything I had was in Bloomberg, and now it's gone. My sister's a smith in Hilltop, but she certainly isn't rich.
A smith in Hilltop?
Yes, her name is Fiona, but I don't know if she would help me out at all. Does this mean I have to stay in the cage?
Swearing everlasting loyalty to me. I'll see what I can do. I'm not gonna make him swear loyalty to me. That's not my style. I love that, like, the first response is time to die.
Thank you for releasing me. I thought I was never getting out of there. Now, care to show me where the exit is?
Sure, follow me.
I really appreciate this. Thank you very much.
Alright, come on. Come on. If you try to screw me, I'm gonna make you the deadest freaking half-orc that's ever been. I knew he was a half-orc before we even talked to him because character model. Humans don't get those sideburns. Come on. Okay. Get back here and then we'll rest because all of our stuff's wearing off.
It looks like the exit there. Thank you for saving me. I don't think I could have made it without you.
Enjoy the bitter cold. Have fun fighting the wolves. Let's see here. Can I rest over here? Man, don't make me just walk outside. I was gonna say, cause like, I'll just zone out, rest, and then zone back in. Don't be pulling that crap on me. I mean, I guess it beats, if anything, sitting for half an hour while your health regenerates, like back in the days of, you know, old and EverQuest. Oof. There's a reason I played paladins and clerics. I'll just leave it at that. Okay, shield of faith, and we'll drop a bowl of strength. Let's see how it does for us. I'm gonna recast that. Screw you, game. Of course, it's like,
you don't like the two, huh? Have another one.
Jerks. All right, let's come in here. Door is presently barred from the other side, but shows signs of recent use. Can we bash it? No. We've been accursed or accosted by DM Fiat, guys. We gotta actually play the adventure. Now. Shit. He's gonna make it. Hey, guys. Oh, there's more than one of them. Are those both lieutenants? Okay, so it seems like the lieutenants are the ones that go for... Oh, no. Not the boar. You leave my boar alone. Boar gonna... No! Mr. Pigglesworth. You vile fiend. That's right, damn it. I cleave into your wounded companion. And then just stand there drooling on myself. Yeah, it looks like they do actually kind of attract wayward gnolls. That's kind of handy. Like, I shouldn't say handy. It's not a good thing. But I can appreciate the nod to not just, you know, having the entire population of the dungeon basically ignoring the fact that we're assaulting the dungeon. Cheriel, it would be great if you'd attack. Thank you. I know you like doing the combat dance, but come on now. I need you to maim things. There we go. How are we looking? 1,500 of that 5,000. That's what I would consider pretty solid progress. All things considered, it could certainly be going slower. The hand axe. We're getting some miscellaneous stuff in here. Nothing really too interesting yet. I really don't expect to just kind of stumble upon any great magic items in here. That's not really the BioWare style. Like, I'm sure there's a magic item or two in here waiting for us, but, oh, I see you over there. But I'm sure we're gonna have to fight for it. I really need to pick up a ranged weapon. Like, we've been picking them up, but I've not been holding onto them. I need to get like a longbow or something that I can just, you know, use to plink away things. No.
Indeed.
No. That's why. Yeah, I saw that line of bullshit coming a mile away. All right. You guys asked for it. It's badger time. The mini mangler is here. I don't know which is mini or the mini or mangler. It's either, I'm traveling with midgets and rabid animals. What do you expect? that badger, it's just having no shit. I love it. Mascot, go. Dorna is just getting the hell beaten out of her because she can't figure out where she wants to be. Here. That should top her off. Or not. I rolled like crap. Still, that was 12 hit points. How much health is she? Jesus Christ, she's got more health than I do. Like, that was 12 hit points. That should have been a decent heal. Apparently our dwarf is tanky. I'm sure she has like, what, an 18 con? Yeah. 18 con, 18 dex, no weapon finesse. Yes, I'm still bitter. And she's casting spells. Dorna, if you die, I don't care. I'll go replace you with the obnoxious half-orc. Maybe he's a proper wizard. You leave my badger alone. You leave him alone! I think there's actually a taunt in this, if I recall correctly. You do have a taunt action. I think it's based around like intimidate or something. Hey there. Hey, Lieutenant. You and me, mano e mano. Oh. Dwarf's getting in from the behind. Rogues do, in fact, do it from behind. Seriously? Better not kill my damn badger. Get out of here. Ugh, violence. Just so much violence. Here, we'll go ahead and use this on Dorna. Heal her up a little more. Much better. See, that's the difference when you're out of combat, as you can see there. I took 20, which basically means I take as long as I need to do it perfectly. And there, it's 22 points of healing for, you know, a shitty little item kit. That's not bad. And there was... Did I actually not take it? I was gonna say, I thought so. Minder Tangle Trap, which I don't know if we'll be able to sell, but I'll hold on to it. And that looks like about it. And we are at 32 minutes, so I'm going to go ahead and call it an episode here. So, as per usual, folks, I want to save in a new slot. Thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time, and I hope this turns out to come through really nicely in the final product. But I will catch you all later. Take it easy.